Switching gears, it may not be on your radar just yet, but this time of the year is when toy companies typically begin shipping their hot ticket items to U.S. retailers. However, a shortage of shipping containers, along with other factors, are sending freight costs through the roof. Prices for shipping containers increased as much as 500%, according to industry group the Toy Association. The situation becomes so urgent that the Toy Association is requesting federal lawmakers and the Federal Maritime Commission to step in to address the shipping crisis. Joining me now to discuss is Steve Passierb, who is the president and CEO of the Toy Association. Great to have you here with us today, Steve. Help us break this down a little bit more. It seems every year there's a crisis leading up to the holiday season, whether it's the COVID-19 pandemic or the general backlog of toys. How significant is this disruption in the supply chain?
Yeah, this is the big one. This is the latest and the greatest disruption, if you will. And in fact, we've seen some companies see 800% increases in container costs if they can get a container. So you're right. August is really the time when the product arrives. The major retailers make their reset at Labor Day to stock those toys into their store. And for many cases, they're still sitting in China or they're still sitting off the port of LA waiting to get offloaded. So it really is a crisis, not just for our industry, which is heavy seasonal, but also all consumer products. We've right now in the middle of a global crisis, which is why it's so hard to get out of this.
And so what does it mean for the upcoming holiday season?
Well, you know, the one thing I think you're going to see supply. There's going to be supply out there. You've seen the major companies make their announcement that they're going to do whatever it takes to get product in. It's really going to impact selection. And from a consumer standpoint, consumers have been preconditioned to wait to Thanksgiving or wait to that gap between Thanksgiving and Christmas. What we're telling consumers now is if you're out there for back to school, lay in some toys, hide them in your trunk, take them home, hide them in the attic, because right now is the time to shop early for toys. Good selection at this point, more selection, it is on the water coming in. But if you're gonna lay back and wait, you may find that that toy your kid has their heart set upon may not be there if you wait for that big pre-holiday sale.
How does that translate into prices?
You know, we've seen some announcements of modest price increases. In many cases, a lot of toy manufacturers have set deals with retailers. They're not able to raise prices. So I think from a consumer standpoint, it's that idea that if you're looking for price off promotions around the holiday season, if selection is low, if sales are hot, you're not going to see your normal price off that you might be waiting for.
Now, this is a key time of the year for these small and large toy manufacturers. How does this impact their bottom lines if they end up raising prices?
It's a huge impact on bottom line, simply because if you were paying $3,000 for a shipping container and you're now paying $21,000 to $24,000 plus added on fees, your profit margins are eroding. In some cases, you know, again, the average price of toy in America sold is $10. So it ranges from that up to obviously, you know, expensive toys. Companies begin to question whether or not this makes any sense. So what you're seeing in our category and other categories is companies starting to make decisions to ship the higher volume things, not the things that are, if you will, the low price points that really American consumers have come accustomed to.
Now, we don't have a chief toy officer here at Cheddar, so you got to help me break down some of the popular toy categories this season.
Well, you know, the amazing thing coming out of this pandemic is there are 11 super categories of toys. So far this year through the first 6 months, 10 of the 11 are up, with the exception of arts and crafts. So you saw a 26% increase in toy sales in 2020, up to $37 billion, another 19 this year, and really across the range. Interesting things are happening. Outdoor toys and sports toys are still hot. They usually have a big hit in the spring and the early summer. They're still selling well. We think going into the holiday season, your major brands that you've always been looking for are going to be there. You know, things that are hot right now are the fidget toys, the Poppets. You're seeing a resurgence of plush, probably driven by Squishmallows, but others. So there is no the hot toy yet this year, but the categories across the board, which is why we're telling consumers to shop early, all continue to show heat.
And so how should consumers plan to avoid delays in shipping? Like, do we have to purchase these toys like now?
Yeah, I mean, we're kind of saying, you know, again, major retailers do their reset for the holiday season around Labor Day. So supply at your major retailers is going to look really good Labor Day and in September. Your local toy store right now is a really important part of our economy. Get out there, talk with them. They have orders coming for mid-October. Make sure they're coming. But it never hurts to shop early. And again, I think the key is we precondition American consumers to wait for the sale. This may be a year where selection is a little bit lower. Product is out there, but the big sale you were hoping on may not occur.
Okay, stick with us, Steve, here. We got to shift gears for a hot second. Our next segment, What Keeps You Going, is brought to you by Dunkin', where we feature the habits of fast-paced and high-energy entrepreneurs and executives who are always on the go. We're here with Steve Passier, who is the president and CEO of the Toy Association. Steve, we got to know, how do you beat the midday slump?
For me, it's caffeine and carbs, and maybe, you know, in other orders. It's also got to get up and move around. I mean, we've been stuck at desks, you know, in our lives anyway. We're stuck at home now. Get up, move around, go for a quick walk. Those are the things that kind of give me that second breath of energy in the afternoon. But carbs and caffeine help a lot.
Okay, that's a solid equation right there. What does being a go-getter mean to you?
You know, it really means taking advantage of every opportunity, being aggressive, looking for those opportunities, trying new things. I think that's a really essential part of our industry because it's a lot like the fashion industry. It's being constantly reinvented. What was hot last year is not hot this year. So you got to be a go-getter. You got to be willing to try new things, go out there, experiment, be willing to fail, because that's where you're going to get your greatest successes.
And we got to know lastly here, what's one app that you couldn't live without?
Couldn't live without. You know, it's funny. I'm trying to get away from social media, which is a really, really tough thing to do. So if I had to be on a desert island with only one, it might just be the Weather Channel. But our industry lives on LinkedIn. So that is probably the one I hit every day early in the morning just to see what's going on, what our member companies are posting about their businesses.
Steve Passier, who is the president and CEO of the Toy Association. Fun job you got over there, Steve. Thanks so much for joining us and breaking these things down for us this morning. Everyone.